आपदम अपहर्तारम दातारम सर्वसंपदम रामाभिरामं भूयो भूयो नमाम्यहम्। श्री शिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद टोल, इवन टुडे इन साउथ इंडिया द साउथ इंडियन पीपल दे कैन नॉट एक्सेप्ट कृष्ण प्रॉपरली। दे थिंक दैट इट इज नॉट यू नो एथिकल अप टू नारायण, लक्ष्मी नारायण इज ओके, राम सीता इज ओके, बट स्टिल टुडे दे कैन नॉट अंडरस्टैंड द एक्सीलेंसी ऑफ भगवान श्री कृष्ण। दे कैन नॉट अंडरस्टैंड, दे ऑलवेज मिसअंडरस्टैंड हिम, बिग प्रॉब्लम। एक्चुअली वी आर वेरी लकी बिकॉज श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु परात्पर अखिलेश्वर, ही वेंट टू साउथ इंडियन टूर टू प्रीच कृष्ण नाम, एंड देन श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु देयर कलेक्टेड टू इम्पॉर्टेंट बुक्स। वन इज इसो यू सी ब्रह्म संहिता फिफ्थ चैप्टर एंड अनदर इज कृष्ण कर्णामृत, बोथ ऑथेंटिक बुक्स यू सी, वेरी गुड बुक। ब्रह्म संहिता कैन गिव ऑल एविडेंस अबाउट कृष्ण तत्व एंड एवरीथिंग, एंड कृष्ण कर्णामृत कैन प्रूव द एक्सीलेंस ऑफ कृष्ण लीला। इज 100% वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बुक्स, वी फॉल गौड़ियस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बुक्स। एक्चुअली पॉइंट इज दैट ब्रह्म संहिता एक्चुअली रिटन बाय ब्रह्मा हिमसेल्फ। एक्चुअली व्हाट ब्रह्मा सॉ थ्रू हिज एस्टेट एंड फिनेंसेस, ही कुड सी एवरीथिंग। यू नो चतुश्लोकी भागवतम, यू नो चतुश्लोकी भागवतम, देयर यू कैन फाइंड दैट भगवान श्री कृष्ण गिविंग इंस्ट्रक्शन टू ब्रह्मा, ज्ञानम परमम गुज्जंग में यद विज्ञान समन्वितम स रहस्यम तदंग ज्ञान गदितंग मया, जवान हम यथाभाव यद रूप गुण कर्म कह तथैव विज्ञानम अस्तु ते मदनुग्रहात्। आई ब्लेस यू, यू कैन ग्रो, यू कैन हैव द नॉलेज ऑफ माई पास्ट टाइम, माई फॉर्म, माई दाम, एवरीथिंग यू कैन गेट, बट आउट ऑफ योर ओन एफर्ट यू कैन नॉट नो, यू कैन नॉट नो। बाय माई ब्लेसिंग यू कैन नो एवरीथिंग, सो आई ब्लेस यू। एंड आफ्टर दैट एट द एंड ऑफ चतुश्लोकी श्लोका देन भगवान श्री कृष्ण गिविंग ब्लेसिंग टू ब्रह्मा, यीशु यू आर बिजी विद दिस क्रिएशन, you are always busy with this creation, but still I bless you, you cannot get hypnotized, nobody can make fool of you, you can get full knowledge. That's why brahma your krishna hite chaturmukh hai krishna seven mukh, this way in you know disciplic succession we are getting our mantra. Though Prabhupada giving a very nice judgment, Mantra Parampara and Bhagavat Parampara, Prabhupada wanted to prove very scientifically, because sometime we see Mantra Parampara is not successful. Sometime in the lineage we see some kind of breakage is there. That time you cannot get in connection with that, you know, previous Acharya. But Bhagavat Parampara is very good. Bhagavat Parampara can give you total knowledge. At the same time, there is no danger. That's why Prabhupada, Krishna Hite Chaturmukh writing, there 50% Prabhupada giving Guru Parampara and 50% giving Bhagavat Parampara to prove that it's all the same, no problem. This way, we are very lucky that we are getting the full knowledge what Brahma got practically, what Brahma saw. He, you know, in the form of Brahma Sangeeta, we are getting everything. Actually, you can see in Brahma Sangeeta, we find Ramadi Kalasu Nana Niyame Natishtan Nana Avataram Akarat Bhuvanesh Kintu Krishna Swayam Samabhavat Paramapumanajo Govindamadi Purusham Tamaham Bhajam. Ramadi, you know, different kind of avatar coming. Namadi kalasu nana niyame natishtan nana avataram akarat bhubaneshu kintu Krishna Swayam Samabhavat Paramapumanajo Govindamadi Purusham Tamaham Bhajam. Here we are find one nice clue that from, you know, Ram, Nishimha, Baraho, all avatar, they are coming from Krishna. Krishna means Govinda, Govinda Madhi Purusham Tamham Bhayami. Govinda is the original personality, Supreme Godhead, from where all avatar are coming. We are getting, actually. Actually, from Krishna, then Baladev first expansion. From Baladev we see four Chaturbhuha, second Chaturbhuha. Then you can find there is, you know, Karana Nava Sai Vishnu. That Karana Nava Sai Vishnu, Mahavishnu, he is the source of all avatar. All avatar, actually from Krishna everything coming, but still, this way we can find from Mahavishnu, from Krishna directly, not directly, but through, we are getting. So Ramchandra, Ram, Baraha, Nishingho, Kurmadev, they are all, you know, Supreme Lord. There is no contradiction, no fighting in this judgment. This tattva is perfect. But still, you see, they are Purna Avatar. If you like to pass this kind of judgment, Ram is less than Krishna, or Baraho is less than Ram, this way, you are going to commit offense, you see. You should not speak this way. They are all Purna Avatar. Ram, Nishingo, Baraho, Kurmo, all Avatar, they are coming. Vudhya, they are all Purna Avatar. Purna Avatar means there is actually Purna Tatya. But there is positive, comparative and superlative degree. In this respect, we can find Krishna's importance is more, because Krishna's excellency, Leela excellency, Banu, Benu Madhuri, Leela Madhuri, Rupa Madhuri, this kind of special things are there. So Krishna is topmost, there is no fighting in it. But sometimes those who are doing bhajan of Ram, they are very sorry, they are always speaking, you say, or we are doing Ram bhajan. Jejan Krishna bhaje sehai var chatur. In Chaitanya Charitamrita Siddhanta is there. Those who are doing Krishna bhajan, they are very clever. But, you know, and Vrindavan Das Thakur also writing sometime, Jagatir Pita Krishna Jaina Bhave Bhaje Bhav Pitridhi Patakir Janme Janmetap. Those who are not doing bhajan of Krishna, they can get, you know, tritap, three modes of, you know, between the different kind of, miseries they are going to suffer. This way, they become very sorry. Why? We are doing Ram bhajan. It is your prejudicial idea. It's not good. We say, see, Krishna is complete. That's why it is written in Shastra, Govinda Madhi Purusham Tamaham Bhajami. But that doesn't mean if you worship Ram, you cannot come out successful, not that. But according to your bhajan, you can climb eternal abode if you come out successful. So if your bhajan is successful, according to your mood, because it is written, according to your bhajan, you can get siddhi. Bhajane chintive jaha siddhite paivataha. I mean, it is written, when you are doing bhajan, what kind of, you know, situation is there inside your heart, what kind of, you know, darshan is there, according to that, you can get siddhi. Those who are doing Ram bhajan, they cannot get Krishna. Not possible. It is not possible. So those who are doing Ram bhajan, they can get Ram. Those who are doing Baraha bhajan, ultimately if they are successful, they can get Barahadev. This way, those who are doing bhajan, they should be very careful about this point. Krishna is not any avatar. He is avatari. All avatar coming from this source. So, Ram, Nishinga, Varaho, they are all avatar. But actually, Krishna is not actually avatar. And Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is also not avatar. They are all avatari. They are all avatari. Supreme Godhead. They are not avatar. So from them, actually from Krishna, we are getting Ram. Now point is that, in Brahma Sangita, it is written that Ram, Varaha, Adi, different kind of avatar coming, but Govinda is the original, you know, Purush, Supreme Godhead. So, actually, and Krishna bhajan is more excellent. Because you can remember in Gaur Lila, someday Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asking Murari Gupta, the Murari, why you are doing Ram bhajan if you can do Krishna bhajan? There is more excellency, it's very, very nice. So whether you do Ram bhajan, Krishna bhajan, is good. But Murari Gupta whole night repeatedly thinking about this matter, this point, because Prabhu giving me instruction, over and again he is thinking about this point, but he cannot leave Ramchandra. Because Murari Gupta is actually Hanumant Lala. He is actually Hanuman. And this avatar, he is actually Murari Gupta. So never he can leave Ramchandra. So he took decision, I cannot violate Mahaprabhu's decision, Mahaprabhu's instruction, Prabhu's instruction, I cannot violate. At the same time, I cannot do Ram bhajan. So what to do? I can do one thing, I can commit suicide. In this number, in Mayapur Dham, I can, he make one knife, sharp edge knife. Especially, he give order and make it. And is keeping in one place. But after that, you see, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming, I mean Gauranga Mahaprabhu, that time Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Nimai. Nimai coming and asking to Murari Gupta, Murari, where is your that knife? You like to kill yourself? Huh? Where is knife? I don't know. Hey, don't speak lie. Then Mahaprabhu from secret place get this knife. Actually, I wanted to test you, Murari. Why I should not break your, you know, rigidity? You have nishtha in Ramchandra because you are Hanuman. Life after life you are doing the service of Ramchandra. Only to test you, I was speaking this way, you need not leave Ramchandra. It is very good. Your nishtha is pakka. You should not beg. This way we can find also that Ishi Rupa Goswami Pad and Sanatana Goswami Pad in their previous home repeatedly requesting the younger brother, Anupam, you should do bhajan of Ram bhajan. Hey, you should do Krishna bhajan. You are doing Ram bhajan day and night, I know. But you should do Krishna bhajan. Krishna bhajan is very excellent. If you do, you can understand. But after repeated thinking over this point, he is thinking and thinking over again. But he cannot, you know, take decision to do Krishna bhajan. Then he is crying in front of Rupa Goswami Pad and Sanatana Goswami Pad, you are my elder brother, but excuse me, I cannot, you know, leave Ram bhajan. I sell my head unto the lotus feet of Sri Ram Lala Ramchandra. How he can stop my Ram bhajan? It is not possible. What to do? Please excuse me. Then Rupa Sanatana also speaking, your nishtha is praka. You can do Ram bhajan. No problem. This way, we are getting this instruction actually. Now point is that, Ram Tattva. Actually, Ram Tattva, I started with one sloka. This sloka is pranam mantra of Ram. Apadam apahartaram dataram sarvasampadam ramavirahamam bhuyo bhuyo namamyaham. Is the pranam mantra of Ramji. Tulsidas ji, one day doing bhajan here, near Gan Gudri in Vrindavan. There one Kach Mandir near there. That spot, Tulsidas ji doing bhajan long ago. He was doing bhajan, but to taste, you know, Krishna Bhagavan coming in front of him and giving darshan. Then Tulsidas ji crying, Prabhu, you are same, I know. Ram ji, my Ishtadev, and you all same. But actually, I have Nishtha in my Ishtadev. So, could you kindly express that Ram Murthy? I like to see Ram, you know, Murthy, because of my Ishtadev. That time, Bhagavan Sri Krishna smiling and giving darshan in the form of Ramchandra. This way we know there is no difference. Ramchandra, Krishna, no different, they are Purna Tattva. But still, there is some speciality, Sanatana Goswami saying, in Sanatana Sikha also you can find in Chaitanya Charitamrita, that Nrisimhadev have some speciality among all avatar, and Ramchandra has some more speciality, Ramchandra. But Krishna avatar is excellent. Krishna is avatari, Krishna is most excellent, you see, this way. Now, like Panchatattva you know already, Panchatattmatakam Krishnam Bhaktarupa Sarupakam, you know. You are daily you are paying Dandavat. But you should know that Paratpara Akhileshwar Swayangrup Bhagavan, this word is Tattva, very important. Swayangrup Bhagavan Krishna and Swayangrup Bhagavan Krishna Chaitanya. That's why Swarup Gosai writing Chaitanyat Krishnat Na Jagati Paratatta Paramiho. Swarup Gosai writing this way, Na Chaitanyat Krishnat Jagati Paratatta Paramiho. Who is Chaitanya? He is Krishna, all the same. They are all Supreme Godhead. But actually point is that from Krishna we are getting Ram. So Panchatattva we can study from Chaitanya Charitamrita, we can know everything. The Panchatattva together is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And more clearly I would say, when you want to know the exact Bhagavat Tattva, so our Guru Varga, our Siddhanta speaking this way, that Bhagavat Tattva is a complete Tattva. Bhagavat Tattva means Bhakta, devotee, Dham, Naam, all paraphernalia, all in together is total Bhagavat Tattva. You cannot break it. Those who are Mahabhagavat Vaishnavas, you know, Bhagavat Tattva is together. That's why you know, many times you hear, I think, Bhakta Bhagavat and Grantha Bhagavat. You know, Bhakta Bhagavat, you know, devotee Bhagavat and Grantha Bhagavat and Grantha Bhagavat. And Bhakta Bhagavat, both important. So if you like to Bhagavat, if you like to know Bhagavatam, then you will have to take shelter of a pure Vaishnava, Bhakta Bhagavat. Otherwise, you cannot know anything about Bhagavat. Bhakta Bhagavat can express Grantha Bhagavat. Though Grantha Bhagavat is equal to Krishna. That's why Sukadeva Goswami, speaking in front of Parikshit Maharaj, Te Rajan, this Bhagavatam is no other than Krishna. Krishna Evahi is just equal to Krishna. No other than Krishna. He is Krishna. So we have no doubt that Krishna and Srimad Bhagavatam non-different. Yes, you should remember it this way. But point is that Panchatattva means, you see, I have no time to explain it today. Panchatattva you know, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, and then first expansion, Nityananda Prabhu from Gauranga Mahaprabhu. After that you can get Advaita Goswai, Mahavishnu Jagatkarta, Mayaya Yasiyuti Adaha, Tasvavatara Evayam Advaita Acharya Swaraha. You see? Then you can get Bhakta Bhagavat, there is Naraji and Gadadhar Sakti. This way you see, this Panchatattva, you can see, find Panchatattva is one, unique Tattva, but manifested in five different forms, but actually unique and one Tattva. This way, I would say, the Ram Tattva is one unique Tattva also. Ram Lakshman, Bharat, Satugna, Chaturdha Agat. Actually written in Bhagavatam, there's Ramchandra is complete Tatta together with, you know, Lakshman, Bharat and Satugna, but in one unique and complete Tatta, but they are manifested in four different form to express Leela, so that we can have a nice teaching out of this Ram, you know, Leela. That's why we know that this fourth tattva is unique tattva or same one tattva. But remember, Dasaraji Maharaj, who is getting big honor in heaven, big honor by Indra, is very special point. And that Dasaraji Maharaj, he was worshipping Ramchandra from very early age. Tetajug, you know, in Tetajug, actually Dasaraji Maharaj, before Ramchandra took birth, before Ramchandra incarnate, actually Dasaraji used to worship Ram Tattva much before. Nobody knows this point, actually. From long time, Dasaraji Maharaj worshipping Ramchandra very, very strong, with strong devotion. After that, Ramchandra taking an incarnation here in this material world. That very deity worshipped by Dasaraji Maharaj is still there in Urupi. If you go there in Urupi, you can find there actually Madhvacharya used to worship Ramchandra at the same time Gopal, you see, what Madhvacharya got from Dwarka, you know, one chandan, big chandan, a heap of chandan given to him, break up, then he finding that Gopal with Dodhimantan Nanda can find there. So, Madhvacharya actually worshipping Krishna at the same time Ramchandra. Now you can put question, why Maharaj? Why? Then you can try to find out the answer. Why? Actually you can see Madhvacharya is Vayu avatar. First Hanumanji came, after that in Dapar Yuga, in, you know, Bhimsen, after that Mukhya Vayu avatar, Mukhya Vayu, principal Vayu, is coming in the form of Madhvacharya. You should know this point. So Madhvacharya means Hanuman itself. Hanumanji coming, a Bhim. So in the form of Bhim, when he took birth as Bhim, he is having Nishtha for Krishna also. And when he was in the form of Hanuman, he was having, in the form of Hanuman, he is permanent, not that. And actually, when he came in the form of Hanuman, that time also, you can see Hanuman worshipping and serving Ramchandra wholeheartedly. That's why, in Madhva Avatar, he is expressing two kind of things. He is also worshipping Krishna, at the same time he is getting that Ramchandra Vigya worshipped by Dasaraji Maharaj. Dasaraji Maharaj doing astute and penance for a long time. After that, he got information that Supreme Lord coming in his room, in his house, in the form of Ramchandra. Actually, Ramchandra he was worshipping. He must be knowing. That's why actually Ramchandra came. First Ramchandra came. Kausalyanandan. Kausalya. And Kausalya, Kaikeyi and Sumitra. Kausalya topmost. And Kaikeyi second and Sumitra third. Anyway, we have some conception that Kaikeyi is very wicked. Everybody is speaking that Kaikeyi is so bad, you know, personality. She is putting Ramchandra in trouble. She is putting Dasaraji Maharaj in trouble. So she is very bad. But nobody knows some secrecy there. In Ram Tattva, those who are doing Ram Bhajan, those who are doing secret Ram Bhajan very nicely, they are knowing all this Tattva. Openly you cannot know this thing. I can come to this point anyway. Ramchandra came in the house of Dasaraji Maharaj. Dasaraji Maharaj is very, very happy. And when Ramchandra came, midday time, at 12 o'clock, when sun is just stopped, noontime, then Ramchandra appear in this material world. And symptom and all star position, so nice and unique, I cannot speak anything about that. Those who are astrologers, they can speak clearly. So you see, so Ramchandra took birth, and so everybody can find very auspicious, you know, everywhere. After that, you see, Ramchandra went took birth, then Dasaraji Maharaj very, very happy, dancing actually. But you should remember, we have the chance to go through Ramayana, Valmiki Ramayana, but nobody knows. Those who are doing Ram Bhajan, those who are having exact information, only they can know that actually Valmiki Muni compiling this Ramayana 60,000 years before Ram incarnation. Nobody knows. Those who are doing Ram Bhajan, exactly having Tattva Gyan, perfect Tattva Gyan, they knowing this. So actually, 60,000 years before Ramchandra, so Valmiki Muni compiling this, you know, Rama. So it's very, we are very, you know, surprised, how is that possible? Because Valmiki Muni, you know, previously Valmiki was one demon, you know, like demon, very notorious personality, he used to kill everybody. Ratnakar Dosu, as a Rishi, he is the son of Rishi, but somehow his brain distorted, he is, you know, Vikritya, so he is doing all ravish activities. Someday Naroji passing that way, then he tied Ramchandra, I mean Naroji Maharaj. Naroji was the, what do you like to get? I like to kill you, I like to get some property you have. I have no property. If you can kill me, you cannot get anything. So I am actually Rishi. So this way, Ram, actually Naraji Maharaj speaking, you are actually every day killing so many, you know, and a person. So you will have to suffer for that. You know, you have to suffer for that. Why you are killing? You have to get reaction for that, heavy reaction. Why should I get, why you are doing? Because I have no source of income. I am killing those people, I am getting some property, I am going to my house, and I am, you know, managing my daily bread, everything. So actually you will have to suffer total. You are doing sinful activities. Why? No, why? Actually all my family members, they are also going to share my... No, nobody can share. Yes, they can share. No. If you disbelieve me, you can go and take information. To your, oh, you are very clever. If I go, you can fly. No, you can tie me with this tree so that I cannot fly, so that I cannot go away. So you go and take information. Then he's going to home, asking, Father, I am doing these sinful activities. You are ready to take some share of my... No, why should I take? You are my son. It is your responsibility to feed me. I am in old age. You cannot take? No. Mother... He is asking to mother, can you take? No. Why should I take? You are doing sinful activities. You will have to suffer. Then nobody like to take. They come back with tears in eyes. Nobody like to take, you know, responsibility for what I am doing, these sinful activities. So you see, you will have to suffer. You are killing so many, you know, person. So you will have to suffer. Life after life. Life after life, you will have to suffer. Oh, can you show me the way out? I can show, but if you believe me, oh, you look, you are sadhu, you are big, you know, rishi. I think I can believe you. Then you speak. Then Naraji Maharaj speaking, you first go and throw everything. Then I like to speak you Naam, Bhagavad Naam. So you will have to chant Bhagavad Naam, then you can get everything what you want. Harinam, out of Harinam, we can get everything, even Brahma taking responsibility of this Harina, universe, out of this power of Harinam, Brahma. Everybody, Shankar. You can find Narad Muni Bajaye Bina Radhika Ramana Nami. This song you can. So everything, Ram, you know, Ram Nam, Krishna Nam, is all beautiful. You can get free of any kind of material clutcher. Nobody can put you in trouble. Ram Nam is so pure. You see? So this way, Narodji want to give advice about this Harinam. You go take bath and come to me. I like to give you Harinam, Ramchand, Ramnam. Then after that you speak Ram. Ram. But he cannot speak Ram. His tongue is so, you know, distorted, he cannot pronounce Ramnam. He is speaking Mara, Mara. Hey, not Mara. Mara means dead body. Mara, not Ram. I cannot speak Ram. Anyway, you go on chanting, Mara, 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 Mara. So, cyclic order, if you go on reciting this, someday you can utter Ram, Ram, Mara. Mathura also. Mathura, this name, is also this way, cyclic order. Mathura, Mathura. You know, Manthan. Again. This way, you see, he is getting advice from Narad Ji Maharaj. Now, taking one bow to take Ramnam daily, but he cannot pronounce. What to do? His tongue is not perfect. He will have to grow perfection first. So, by the advice of Narad Ji, he is now reciting Ram, Ram, Mora, 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 Mora. After that, he is pronouncing Ram someday. One Ramnam, one Krishna Nam, if you can utter, then you can purify yourself. Infinity pure, you are doing some sinful activities, all can be erased at a time with one Ram Nam. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving this same advice when those devotees going to take darshan of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Purushottam Dham, you know. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving advice, if you can, who is Vaishnava Prabhu? If you can hear one Krishna Nam from one devotee, know it for sure he is Vaishnava. That one Krishna Nam, don't think that is ordinary Krishna Nam. Because Nam is there, Namabhash is there. Namabhash is not actual Nam. And Namaparad, Namabhash, and actual Nam. Actual Nam means pure Nam. So regarding Ajamil Siddhanto, I like to speak, but time cannot permit. Ajamil somehow, when he got the association of Vishnu Duta, you know, somehow he can remember at the time of death, he could remember that Vishnu Dut, they are discussing. So you can think it this way, that though he was pure Brahman previously, pure Brahman, after that he loses all power, after that when he had the chance of, you know, hearing this, you know, conversion between Vishnu Dut and Jamdut, conversion going on, you know, conversation going on, that time you can find that he heard everything. That's why he got some information about Bhagavad Tattva. So after that, when Jamaduta gone, he took decision to go to Sahasradhara in Haridda and started bhajan. And after that, he got Siddhi. So, in Bhagavatam, you can find some poem, Ajamil Opi Agad Dhamam. Ajamil also went to Dham. What do you mean? What do you mean, actually? So, you can do all evil activities, you can sing Ram Ram, you can speak, and you can cut your aparad daily, and sinful activities you are doing, again you are doing Ram Ram. No, not that, actually, not that. So this way, Ajamil somehow got the chance to Bhaktivinoda Thakur actually speaking, and also those who were writing Biswanatha Chakravarti, somehow Ramnam appeared. Somehow. That's why actually, after that he is doing bhajan. After doing bhajan, he attended Siddhi. Ajami Lopi Agadhyamam, not that without bhajan, Ajami went there. This way, you can find those who are reciting Chaitanya Charitamrita of Chaitanya, they sometimes explain wrongly. They say, Narottama Thakur speaking, Navajito Dei Premdhan. Without bhajan, Gauranga can give prema. Premdhan. Again, that Narottama Thakur also writing, same Narottama Thakur writing, Sadhan Saran Nilat Atena Karohela. Your bhajan and, you know, thinking, when smaran, you should not show any negligency. Then you cannot come out successful. Nobody knows. This way, actually, Tata Siddhanta, you should hear, you should learn from a perfect Vaishnava, pure Vaishnava. Otherwise, big problem. You can lose your position, actually. That's why, when, you know, in Gaur, you know, Chaitanya Leela, in Purushottam Dham, a material kavi, poet, came to recite some writing in front of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then before that, it was a rule that he should speak what he write in front of Sarva Gosai. After if Sarva Gosai approving, then they can approach Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But Sarva Gosai, in starting, become very angry. You are doing committing of wrath unto the lotus feet of Jagannath and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You should stop your writing. You actually atottogo tottoborne oiche dosa hai. Those who are not knowing any tattva, if they are going to write anything, there can be rasabhas and sadhyan siddhanta virodh. So a big problem. So you can go and try to know all siddhanta from Vaishnav. Jao Bhagavat paro Vaishnav sthane. Ekanto asraya karo Vaishnav, Chaitanya charane. So this way, Sarva Gosai giving advice. So you know, actually, this Valmiki Muni now writing, when through this mantra is attending Siddhi, after that he started writing Ram Leela or Ramayana. How? Because you know, Nam and Nami, Nam and Navi Avinna, name and Krishna non-different, Ram and Ramnam non-different. So when Valmiki Muni reciting Ram, 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 through this Ram Nam, he can see all Leela. Because inside Ram Nam, inside our Mahamantra, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, you can see all Leela, everything. You need not jump. You cannot do Raganuga Bhajan out of his own effort. You cannot do. Rupanuga Bhajan is not possible this way. You cannot jump. You cannot jump and cross this material world. It's impossible. I can discuss about this point sometime after, not today. So, Vikriditam Brajavadu Viridancha Vishnu, I can discuss this sloka, what Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, what Prabhupada speaking, what Vishwanath Chakravarti was speaking, what Siddhaswami was speaking, you should know everything and get information. Then you can know everything. So now, actually, inside Mahamantra, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. If you go on chanting this Harinam, Sunday, if you can attend Siddhi, you can see all Leela inside this Mahamantra. Inside this Mahamantra, you can find Radha, Govinda, all paraphernalia, Dham, Leela, everything you can find from Harinam. You need not jump. If you are successful through Harinam, you can see everything. It is written. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, all Guru Varga, those who are doing bhajan, they can prove it 100%. So you should not disbelieve it, this point. So when he is chanting Ram, 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 he can see all Ram Leela, so now he is writing. What he is watching through Ram Ramnam, he is writing in Sanskrit. Actually, in their sampradaya, this is the conception going that this Tulsidas ji is same. Valmiki Muni came in the form of actually Tulsidas. That's why Tulsidas ji started writing Ramayana in Sanskrit, but in lucid form, very sweet way, in Varanasi. But Vishwanath, Kashi Vishwanath, not agree with Tulsidas ji. That's why every day Tulsidas ji writing, and morning time when he again sit for writing further, he find there is back end, no writing there, all white page. Why? He is crying, every day I am writing Raman, every day I finding page back, gone, all writing gone, vanished, how possible? Every day he is facing same problem, then he is crying and going to Vishwanath to ask this question, what problem? Have I done any mistake or aparad? Why this kind of problem happening? Could you kindly answer me? I cannot know, I am in, problem. Then he started crying and fasting without water, paying dandavat to Kashi Vishwanath. I cannot take water until and unless you give me answer why this kind of problem I am facing. Then Kashi Vishwanath came in dream, blessing, O Tulsi, I am sorry to speak you, that Valmiki Muni, in the Valmiki Muni already writing in Sanskrit. So you should write in very, village language. You should write very, very sweet way. So that common people, those who are common people, village people also, those who are not educated enough, they can also realize this Ram Leela. So you will have to write in very, very simple language. Chaupai Chanda. Chaupai. It is taken from Bhagavatam. Chaupai Chanda, actually Tulsidas ji, writing from Bhagavatam also. Because he is watching different kind of Chanda is there. Different kind of Chanda. In whole Bhagavatam you can find different kind of Chanda and different kind of, writings you can find there. So this way, you see, actually point is that Tulsidas ji now came to know that, this is the reason for why I cannot complete my writing. So he took decision, he promised in front of Bhagavan Vishwanath giving blessing, that you can complete your writing very sweet way, very lucid way. Because this, Valmiki Muni writing Ramayana, but those who are reading Ramayana, you can approach them, you can ask them, this Tulsidasi Ramayana is more and more sweet. Tulsidasi Ramayana is more and more sweet, actually. Valmiki Ramayana is not so sweet. And why? Because we know Tulsidas is Bhakta. So when Bhakta touching, Ram Leela, then it has become more sweet. In Bhagavatam it is this argument given, Sukho Mukhad Amrita Dava Sangyutam, it is written. So when bird, touching one fruit, mango or any sweet fruit, then the sweetness of that mango grows. This way we come to know, actually Bhakta Bhagavat, when touching any fruit, any scripture, it becomes very sweet. This way we come to know that Tulsidasi Ramayana is more and more sweet. One point I would like to explain in front of you, that Tulsidas ji, when writing Ramayana, he started Ramayana in Varanasi. But after that, first he was in Ayodhya, after that he started Bhajan, Varanasi he started writing, after that he went to that place, what name? At the bank of Ganga, there, in MP one place. Chitrakoot. Chitrakoot is a nice place, very holy, very, very holy place. There you can find the spot of, bhajan spot of Tulsidas ji. Tulsidas ji for long time doing bhajan there, and actually Tulsidas ji when doing bhajan, he is serving Ramchandra this way, every day, making garland and chandan, and going to temple to offer it. One day, he is crying. He cannot see anything. is that, you know, is making chandan, rubbing and crying, today is the appearance day of Ramchandra, but I am blind, I cannot see Ramchandra. I am trying to write Ram Leela. How is that possible? I don't know. He is rubbing. At the same time, Ramchandra appear in front of him. He cannot see. He is tear, full of tears. After that, he could watch. Ramchandra speaking, I already come to take your garland and, you know, flower and chandan. Then he is very, very happy, you see. This way, he is successful. After that, he is writing more and more. Actually, when Tulsidas ji was in Ayodhya, that time every day Tulsidas ji used to go to hear Ramayana, Valmiki Ramayana, every day. One day one thing happens. Every day it was the usual rule. It was the usual rule that Tulsidas ji used to cross the, you know, cross the, you know, border of Ayodhya and go to pass urine and stool. He is staying in such a place so that if he goes a little bit, he can cross the border. Like here, Hathras, you can find Hathras, one junction. It is the end point, Baldavji, end point, you know. And Haryana, one point, you know, Haryana, one point, there is one. Marginal point. Marginal point doesn't mean that dham is very, you know, finite conception you should not have. Though we externally we find some limitation, within this limitation we find that Ayodhya dham, this, you know, Navadip dham, this Vrindavan dham coming, but still there is no limit. There is Rabindranath Tagore writing this way. Simar maje asim tumi. Simar maje asim tumi. You are actually infinity. Yashoda ma cannot tie you. If you don't express your own willing, Yashoda ma cannot tie you in Damodar, you know, by, you know, rope, you know, because it's not possible. So this way we know that dam is actually vibhutattva. Vibhutattva means infinity. Infinity, you should not have this kind of finite conception about dham. So I explained this tattva many years before. Also repeatedly I like to speak this point also. So this Vrindavan dham, you can find within some limit, you can find Vrindavan dham. But that doesn't mean you can put Vrindavan dham within some limit. It's not possible. Externally it seems, but it is not finite tattva. Infinite tattva it is. Not, you cannot confine it within finite tattva. Anyway, so externally we can find some border point of dham. We do Churasikos 84 cross parikrama. Usually that time we can find. That time we are going to Sekshai here, there, marginal point. We cross and find. This way, Tulsidas ji also wanted to cross this, you know, marginal border of dham. Usually, it was the usual practice of Tulsidas ji to cross the border and go outside to pass urine and stool. One day, actually every day, Tulsidas ji, one pot full of water, because that time no latrine. They used to go to field. Actually, Tulsidas ji going with a pot full of water to do saucha karma. After there some residue of water left in pot, he used to throw in a bush, you know, jar. You know, some thrown briksha, some trees, useless trees. Some they used to throw every day. It was the usual practice. Every day coming, some water residue, then used to throw every day. One day, one ghost speaking. Tulsidas, who's speaking? Actually, I am ghost. You are ghost? Is speaking, what kind of benefit I can do for you? Why? Because every day you are giving water to me. I am giving water to you? No, I am not giving. No, every day while you are coming back from field, you are giving the rest, that Every day you have some residue water you are throwing here. I am staying here. So every day I am getting water from you. So I like to render some service for you. What kind of service you need? I can. You ghost. What kind of service you can give? Well, can you give Ramchandra to me? I like to get Ramchandra, lotus feet of Ramchandra. Well, I cannot give exactly, I cannot give the lotus feet of Ramchandra, but I can give you way, I can show you way out. Way out? What kind of way? Way out? You know, every day you are going to attend Ramkatha there, Valmiki Muni, Valmiki Ramayana, you are going to. Yes, every day I am going. There you can find one leprosy disease. One bhakta devotee is coming and he is staying in a corner, and when Ramayana starting he is coming and sitting, hearing Ramayana. After Ramayana over, he flies. So what? He is actually Hanumant Lal. Hanuman? Yes, he is Hanumant Lal. You can go and catch him forcefully. Then he can give Ram. Oh, really, today I can watch. And he is going to attend that Ram Katha. He is watching. After Ram Katha started, one man coming, leprosy with blanket, you know, covered up, and attending Harikatha, hearing Ram Katha, after that going away. Then that day, Tulsidas ji took resolution, anyway I cannot allow him to fly. I can catch him anyway, by the grace of Ramchandra. He took decision this way. After that, when Ramkatha is over, he started flying. He run and catches lotus feet. Hey! Leave me. I am actually leprosy disease. I know who you are. No, I am leprosy disease. No, I know you are. Who you are? You actually Hanumant Lal. No, I am not. Oh, I know. I cannot leave you. He catch forcefully. Then Hanumanji appear and bless him. I bless you. What you want? I like to get the lotus feet of Ramchandra. Well, you can come out successful. Hanumant Lala giving, you know, blessing to him. This way Tulsidas ji compiling Ramayana. One day, appearance day of Ramchandra, I told you just now. In Chitrakoot, he is writing, he is crying. I am blind, I cannot see Ramchandra. So anyway, he is writing. But how to, today I see the appearance of Ram Lala. In Ayodhya, everybody dancing and singing. But how to write this point? I like to write what I am watching. I like to write in language. But how to write? Because I cannot compare Ramchandra with any material objective. I like to compare Ramchandra with sun god. No, it is not possible. The sun is very, you know, hot. Ramchandra is very cool. So, better I can compare with moon. Is good? No, moon has also some scandal, some spot. So, how to compare Ramchandra, how to write? Then, actually, Tulsidas ji, started writing that how I can compare Ramchandra with, in the days I cannot find. Usually we compare Guru Pad Padma or Supreme Lord or any Vaishnava with the petals of Padma. Padma Aksha, Charan Padma. This way we explain. But actually Tulsidas ji now crying how to write this point. Then he is now watching how to, what to do. After that, he cannot find any object with which he can compare the eyes and the lotus feet of Ramchandra. Then after that, he is get defeated. After that writing, that the Ramchandra, how to look? Ramchandra is same as Ramchandra. We cannot compare Ramchandra with anybody, anything. So this way, Tulsidas ji writing in his own language, Tulsidas ati ananda nirakhake padarvinda. So after that he is writing, So Tulsidas ji writing the Ramchandra is just equal to Ramchandra. I find nothing with which I can compare the lotus, you know, face of Ramchandra. This way is writing. So after that, you know, he compiled all Raman. This Raman, in this Raman, you can know, because Raman commentary is also there. If Raman is there, there's commentary is also there. They can find, I heard from different place, those who are doing Rambhajan, they actually, you can see that Koike is very wicked lady. But as per their Siddhanta, is very secret Siddhanta, we know that Ramchandra, you know, took birth in the lap of Kausalya, Kausalya Nandan. But actually, Koike used to love Ramchandra more and more, like mad. One fraction of a second, she cannot stay without Ramchandra. It is written there. Then how is that possible that she sending, out of jealousy, she is sending Ramchandra for exile 14 years. How is that possible? Nobody can make any meaning of this. How is that possible? Then those who are writing commentary, they are speaking, is a secret Siddhanta. Ramchandra always taking prasadam in the lap of Koikeyi. Koikeyi. Koikeyi always feeding him in lap, in cradle, always, every time, taking care of Ramchandra. One day, when Ramchandra grew up, one day, Ramchandra crying, coming in front of Koikeyi and asking, "Mother, I like to ask one gift from you." "What gift you ask from me? Can you give me? I can give my life also." "Really so? Then I like to ask one thing from you as a gift. But you cannot say no. First you promise." Then Koike is speaking, "No, I cannot say no. Any kind of difficulty I can meet, but I can keep my promise." "Then you will have to do one thing. You can send me in exile, because you know three kind of boon. One boon you keep, because in future you can ask from my father Dasarath. My father wanted to give you three boons, one boon due, so you can ask that boon from him, that I want to send Ramchandra to exile for 14 years." Then he see, get faint. "How I can ask? You already promised me. You can do. And you can ask from Dasarath Maharaj, I mean your husband, my father, to make Bharat king of this kingdom. You will have to ask this point. Otherwise I cannot do my lila. For what? The reason for why I am coming, appear in this material world, I cannot do my lila. You will have to complete your promise. You promised me, so you will have to do it." Then Koikeyi, he was thinking over and again, how is that possible? My heart breaking. But I promise, in front of Ram, I cannot ignore, so I'll have to do. Then, and only then, from Dasarath, he is asking this boon. Then Dasarath, you know, become very, very sorry. He is, you know, got fainted. He is falling down. "You are actually witch, dining you are. How you can ask?" But she keeps silence. You don't answer anything. So actually, Ramchandra asking this boon from him, from her, because otherwise Ramchandra cannot do this kind of lila. So this way, but before, I like to speak one thing, that this Muni, what is the name? Muni? Vishwamitra Muni. Vishwamitra Muni, one day coming to Dasaraji Maharaj, Dasaraji Maharaj paid dandavat to him, "I want to get two of your son, because you have four sons, Ram, Laksham, Bharat, Satugno. I like to get two of your sons to kill Taraka Rakshasi. One big, you know, Rakshasi is there. I'll have to kill. Because we cannot do bhajan perfectly, they are disturbing us, so we'll have to get Ram. But then, actually, Dasarath Maharaj don't want to leave Ramchandra. He is very sorry. He is sending Bharat and somebody. But after that, this Vishwamitra could realize and come, return. You will have to give Ramchandra your heart to me. I can give you back Ramchandra after. I have to go. Then after the Ramchandra, going Ramchandra and Lakshman going actually, Lakshman also going, and in the midway, Vishwamitra asking, which way we should go? Why? You are asking, this way is very shortcut, and this way is there is one big problem. The Taraka Rakshasi is there. And that way is long way where there is no problem. Which way you like? He is saying, I like this shortest way. Then he could realize Ramchandra. After that he is facing the Taraka Rakshasi, killing Taraka Rakshasi. After that reaching, you know, Mithila. Kingdom of that, you know, Janak Raja, there. And there in garden, in one nice garden, Lakshman, Ramchandra and Vishwamitra wanted to take rest. A very nice garden, outside this kingdom. Very nice garden, they want to take rest. After that, Vishwamitra Muni knowing that very shortly, there is a marriage ceremony of Sita Devi. The daughter of, you know, Dasaraji Maharaj, Janakraj, Janakraj Mahabhagavat, big Bhagavat, Mahabhagavat. Rajarshi. Raja, king, at the same time Rishi. Big title is enjoying. So after that you see, in garden, Ramchandra taking rest, because Gurudev asking me, any point, Vishwamitra Muni asking, Ramchandra is very humble mood, a polite mood, is saying, Gurudev, what you want, that I can do. Very polite mood. Actually, Ram Avatar and Krishna Avatar, two specialities there. Ram Avatar is Maryada Purushottam and Krishna Avatar is Lila Purushottam. So here in this Ram Avatar, in each and every fraction of second, Ramchandra wanted to establish Maryada, this rules and regulation, you know, how to pay dandavat, how to pay respect to elderly person. This way, Ramchandra never liked to break any rules and regulation. This is Maryada Purushottam. This way, we find any time this Muni asking Gurudev, asking anything, Ramchandra speaking, Ji Gurudev, what you want to do, I can do. I have no personal opinion. Any time, asking. Then one day, actually, Vishwamitra Muni asking, actually, Dasarathji Maharaj coming nearby. Do you like to see the lotus feet of Dasarathji Maharaj, your father? Because long time gone, for long time he is traveling here and there with Rishi. So Ramchandra speaking very politely, Gurudev, as you like, I have no personal opinion. If you like to take me there, I can take darshan. If you don't like, I cannot take darshan. As you like. This way, always humble mood. One day, actually, Vishwamitra Muni took information, very shortly, there is going to be a big jagya. Haradhanu, one big, you know, bow and arrow, you see? Giving by, you know, Shankar, those who can break, he can marry Sita Devi. So, that's why, now, Vishwamitra Muni took decision, I can take Ramchandra in this Sabha, to prove that he is Supreme Lord. Because I know, nobody knows. So, that's why, he took Ramchandra, also Lakshman, together with Lakshman, they are all going to that Sabha. There actually Ramchandra sitting very politely, humble mood, very, Lakshman also sitting and Gurudev also sitting there. So, one by one, everybody trying to break that, you know, bow. But nobody can do. After that, by the order of Gurudev, Gurudev giving order, now you go. It is your time. You go and break. After this, going and taking up this bow and break from middle. Very easily. Like you see, cane, sugar cane, you know. Yes, break. Like on very, you know, stick, break up. Then everybody could understand he is not ordinary personality, you know. He is supreme personality. Then after that, Sita Devi with garland in hand, like to give garland to Ramchandra. But Ramchandra now standing, but Sita Devi cannot reach up to that point because Ramchandra is long figure. Sita Devi cannot reach up to that point. Because Gurudev not giving any instruction. So Gurudev now giving instruction to Lakshman to solve this problem. Because Sita Devi is standing. She cannot give garland to Ramchandra. Ramchandra long. So what to do? Sita Devi, you know, now Gurudev giving indication to Lakshman to solve this problem. Then Lakshman doing one thing. Lakshman now going to touch the lotus feet of Ramchandra to take the food dust. Then usually it is the rule, when Lakshman touching lotus feet, then Ramchandra swinging his head and embracing Lakshman. That time, Sita Devi getting chance to give the garland. Everybody shouting. Now, very, very nice point actually. After that, you see, then Kaikeyi, you know, now asking this boon. When Sita already came here, I am speaking in gist actually, very short. After that they are staying in kingdom, then Dasarathji Maharaj took decision to make Ramchandra king of this Ayodhya. Everybody dancing, everybody is shouting, everybody singing, but actually Kaikeyi asking this boon, last boon from Dasarathji Maharaj. Then Dasarathji Maharaj for 3 days, he is just fainted. He cannot respond. What happens? Ramchandra coming asking, but actually Kaikeyi asking this boon. Ramchandra laughing, it's nice. My brother Bharatji, Bharat can, I can make Bharat king of this kingdom. There he is proposed. Then Ramchandra took decision to go to forest exile for 14 years. Then actually Ramchandra when took step, wanted to go away from kingdom, then Dasarathji Maharaj almost dying. Dasarathji Maharaj cannot see anything without Ram. Ram is heard. Now he heard the Ramchandra taking preparation to go to exile. Then after that Sita Devi saying, I cannot live without you. If you like to take me, it's okay. Otherwise I am going to die. I must go with you. Because without you I cannot live. Then Sita Devi coming. After that Lakshman took decision, Je elder brother, you must take me with me because Sita Devi, you know, and you there together, I have the chance to serve you too, so you must take. No, you stay here. No, I cannot stay. I must go with you. Then also he took decision to go with, you know, Ram. So first Ram, then Sita, and last Lakshman, leaving this Ayodhya city, kingdom, going to forest, and all creatures, they are crying, blasted into tears. They cannot live as if they are going to die. But still, Ramchandra took decision, full decision, 100%. I must live, because I must keep the promise of my father, because my father promised, I must protect his promise, I must go. Pitishatta Palan. So he is going to forest. After that he is reaching Dandakaranya here, there. I mean, from Ayodhya, you know, geographical factor you can find. From UP, you can find MP. There are big forests there. So from Ayodhya, they are going to forest. And they are going and going. Then gradually they are meeting different kind of rishis, Because those rishis, they are doing bhajan in Dandakaranya here, there. First they going to Chitrakut. There Ramchandra, Lakshman and Sita staying for long period. After they took decision to go to meet Mandapa Muni. There also, after that, he is going to meet Gautami Muni Ashram there. This way they are chain wise going forest to forest, Banat Banam. From here to there they are going. After that Dandakaranya going. And one point I would like to explain you, that while Ramchandra traveling in forest, that sometime he is meeting Guhak Chandal, very nice friend actually, and Ramchandra making deep friendship with Guhak Chandal, crossing the river. Guhak Chandal help him to cross river. In the meantime, from Ajodhya, Bharatji Maharaj crying, coming here to take back Ramchandra back there in kingdom. Ramchandra is saying, no, I cannot go back. I like to protect the promise of my father. You will have to go there and protect the kingdom. Father almost going to die. He give information, still, I cannot break the promise of my father. You go back. Then Bharatji Maharaj coming back, with the karam, karam means wooden chapal, taking wooden chapal in head and coming back to Ayodhya and putting this wooden chapal there in throne, singhasan, and worshipping that, you know, wooden chapal, karam, with full respect that it is Ramchandra. Ramchandra purna vastu. Ramchandra, if he living in karam, it is also purna. Purna, the concept of purna is there. If Ramchandra giving any karam, it is also purna. It is not partial. Counterpart of any purna vastu is also purna. Purna sa purna madaya purna meva avasishyate. That's why Bharatji Maharaj putting this, you know, karam on throne, worshipping daily and, you know, running this kingdom. But himself staying in one place, underground, we're doing tapasya, and every day what he is eating, some rice, he is collecting some rice, Ram, collecting some rice. After that, when sun is almost going to set, then with cow urine, gomutra, he is boiling that rice and eating that rice. This way, big astute and finances, with all torn cloth, he is not going to change cloth. No, it's on dirty clothes, but he is also always sorry. When Ramchandra not with him, this was a feeling of separation, putting him in big trouble all the time. But remember, Ramchandra is running his kingdom this way. Now, in the meantime, Ramchandra traveling different forests, then after that reaching Dandakaranya. Dandakaranya is big spot, is covering some spot of Andhra, some sport of, I've been there just 1 year before. Dandakaranya is big spot, is some Andhra spot, some MP, big spot, big forest, miles after miles, I cannot, you know, measure. There, those are rishis, they are doing bhajan there. They took decision to embrace Ramchandra, because Ramchandra is so nice purush, so nice looking. We cannot leave Ramchandra. We like to give Ramchandra as his wife. But Ramchandra knowing everything, Ramchandra speaking, this my incarnation, this avatar, is Marjada Purushottamo. I cannot break any rules. In this life, I can accept only one wife, Sita. I cannot accept anybody. But next life, when I am coming in the form of Krishna, I can fulfill all your desires. This life is not possible. So those Dandakaranya rishis, they took resolution, anyhow we are going to get the association of this Purushottama, be it in the form of Ramchandra or in the form of Krishna, because Ramchandra is speaking this way. Even when Ramchandra coming back after long time in between, I am speaking this point. When Ramchandra doing jagga, when Sita taking leave, going underground. You know, Sita going underground. There is so many points. I cannot explain. Time is very limited. Sita went going underground. Then, when Ramchandra doing big, big jagya, then it is the rule. You will have to bring your wife and stay with wife to complete the jagya. Each and every time, Ramchandra used to make Sita vigraha. Vigraha of Sita with gold. With gold. Golden Sita. Every time. This way, hundreds of Sita. Hundreds of Sita. They also took birth in this Krishna Leela. You don't know. You know. It is written there. Very secret point. So after that, when he is reaching Mandapa Muni Ashram, from there reaching Gautama Muni Ashram, there one point happens. A big point I like to discuss, you know, this point, touch this point only. There is Sabari. Sabari, you know? Sabari. Gautama Rishi, his wife, is very, very pretty lady. So somehow, by the desire of Ramchandra, it happens. Otherwise, not possible. Sargaraj Indra, feeling some attraction, somehow doing some mischievous activity. After that, Gautamini came to know and giving cards, you can become stone. Then she is crying. I have no fault, I don't know. He came in the form of, you know, your form. My husband you are. So I thought you are my husband. This way, after that went crying, then blessing him well. When in Dapar Yug, Ramchandra coming, in this Yug, Ramchandra again taking birth, he can come here somehow, he can touch you, you can get free of these scars. Otherwise not. This way, Ramchandra knowing everything, Supreme Lord, he came here and this ashram, both to purify this ashram, and those rishis there staying here, and touching the stone, again Ahalya getting his old form. After this, one point is there. You can see there is a Sabari. Sabari is Vilni Bai. Vilni. Vilmin is very low caste. They are actually, you know, staying in forest. They are staying in forest, low grade people. Yeah. Ipman. Ipman, you know? Ipman, they are actually. They are not educated, education, nothing. Low caste, very. Then this Sabari, she is great devotee of Ramchandra. Somehow she is very interested to serve this ashram of Gurudev, because Gurudev respect him, Gurudev love her. So he got some advice from Gurudev. Gurudev told him, Sabari, someday you can meet Ramchandra here. You will not go anywhere. You can serve this ashram. It is my blessing to you. So Sabari, doing seva for long time from childhood, doing this seva for long time, and chanting Ram, 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 this way. Though she is from low caste, but those who are doing Krishna bhajan, Ram bhajan, they are not at all impure. They are most, mean, a purified personality. Nobody knows this Siddhanta. Actually, someday, Sabari, in front of those rishis, the Sabari went to get some water from that pond. There was very nice lake with lotus flower in, you know, lake. But those rishi, they are shouting, "Hey, don't touch the tongue. We are taking water, drinking and, you know, taking bath there. How dare you take, you know, attaching this?" Then as and when they shout and speaking all rubbish against Sabari, then in the meantime, that tongue, tank, actually, the pond, dry up. There is no water, no flower, nothing. Then those rishis, they are speaking, "It is for you. It is for you. We are not getting. It's the only source of water we are, you know, suffering for you. Why you touch? That's why you are losing." She is afraid. She is crying. "Oh, I have done mistake doing Ram now, oh Gurudev. What kind of mistake I have done?" Then Ramchandra rowing, "Oh, everything. Ramchandra wanted to prove it is not the fault of Savari. It is your fault. For why this pond dry up? You have committed many aparath unto the lotus feet of Savari. Ramchandra now coming. Ramchandra asking Savari, can you go take trouble to get some water from that lake? So there is a small amount of water still residue. She is looking at Ramchandra frightened. If I go to take water again, they can beat me. How to go? Savari, you go. Savari looking at Ramchandra. Savari, you go get some water from me. What to do? Savari again go. Because Ramchandra giving water, Supreme Lord, she is going in very frightened mood and going to touch that tank. Even when Savari touching the tank, again that tank become like previously, full of water, very nice water, and this pond is full of nice water, and you know, lotus flower, everything. Then those rishis, they could realize, oh, it was our fault, big aparad. Then they beg pardon from Savari. Savari, excuse us, we couldn't realize that you are so pure, we chide you, please excuse us. This way Ramchandra traveling in forest, Rishyasinga Parvat, there meeting with Sugriv, Ramchandra, you know, Hanumanji also there. Then Sugriv, Ramchandra making friendship with Sugriv, friendship with Hanuman also, and from then time onward, Hanumanji making big seva, big way, with full life. Hanumanji serving Ramchandra. Anywhere Ram Lakhan want to go, they like to take Ram and Lakhan here and fly from here and there this way. And someday Ravan, Kumbhakarna, Kamsa, Jarasandha, they are all Nirvisheshvadi, formless Brahma. They respect Brahman, but they like to kill Krishna, Ram. Kamsa like to kill Krishna. Jarasandha like to kill Krishna. But they respect Brahmin. They are so foolish, actually. So, this way they are actually Mayavadi. You know, Mayavadi? They don't believe Krishna or Ram, nothing. So, now Ravan, one thing happened. Now this spot is, you see, this spot is near, you know, Maharashtra, the Nasik. One spot is Nasik. One day, Sita Devi is there in his Bhajan Kutir, there, and Ram Lakshman, there they are staying, collecting fruits and everything, Lakshman, you know, collecting. And one day, Marish, one, messenger, I mean, one dut of Ravan, is traveling here and there. So one day, actually, Marich coming in front of, you know, Sita Devi. So Ramchandra and Lakshman there, say Sita Devi watching, this very nice, you know, deer. I like to get that. It is golden color, so nice. But you see, it is actually forest. There is some kind of witch and ghost there. They can take this kind of form. You should not believe. No, I like to get it. You can go and catch it. Catch that deer for me. Ramchandra, what to do? Ramchandra going to catch that deer, Marich. Then Lakshmanji is there to protect Sita Devi. But after that, Marich shouting, because they are actually Rakshas. They having some special power to imitate the tone of Ramchandra, to take the form of Ram. They can do it. They are Rakshas actually. They have some power. So from distance, when Marich find the Ramchandra attacking, so to get escape, he is shouting with a tone of Ramchandra, hey, Lakshman, save me! This way. From here, Sita Devi Vajin, your brother in problem. You go now. You go, Ram, ready. Lakshman is saying, not possible. Ramchandra cannot be in trouble. Well, you will have to go. Just as hear the sound of Ramchandra, you have to go. Lakshmanji not ready to go. Then he is speaking all rubbish. I know why you like to stay here. Huh? If your brother, elder brother die, then you can get my... What you say? You are my mother. And now I am going. Don't speak that way. I am feeling pain. This way you should not speak. I never look you. I always see your lotus feet. This way when well Lakshan going away in search of Ram, with arrow putting some mark, demarcation. Babi, don't go out of this mark. If you go, then big problem. Well, I cannot go. Then when gone, in search of Ramchandra, then in forest itself he find Ramchandra there, no problem. But that deer is already shot up by arrow. He is actually Rakshas. He is not actually deer. But in the meantime here, long distance, in the meantime Ravan coming with a base of sannyas, with danda and everything, you know, kamandul, you know, water pot, Bhiksham Dehi in front of the bhajan kutir. Sitadeva watching one, you know, sannyasi coming, I should give bhiksha. Then Sitadevi getting some bhiksha from, well, take. I cannot take bhiksha this way. You will have to come here and give me. I cannot go outside. Please you come and take bhiksha. I cannot go there. You will have to come and give me bhiksha. Otherwise I am going back. You have to take decision what to do. Because you are grihastha. From grihastha's house when sannyasi going away, big problem. Then Sita Devi crying, what to do? Lakshman speaking, not going, not to go. But she is actually Ravan, that is. Then after that, Sita Devi crossing this border, because actually Ravan already tested. He wanted to cross this border. As and when he is going to cross this border, some fire coming up. Then he took decision, some problem is there. I cannot go inside. Then after that, he is asking bhikha. Then Sita Devi breaking rule and coming out of that bhajan kutir and coming to give bhiksha. Then at the same time, Ravan catching his hand, in her hand, and flying. Then Sita Devi crying, bachao, bachao, save me, Ravan, ha, 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 laughing. With chariot, put in chariot, watching, and in one hand, you know, he is actually with chariot going towards, Lanka. And then Sita Devi crying, Sita Devi doing one thing, all ornament opening and throwing in forest so that somehow if my husband can know, Lakshman can know that this is the ornament given by Ramchandra or Jasarath Maharaj, so he can identify this is not a special kind of ornament actually. So I started distributing, throwing in different forest. In the meantime, Jatayu, one of nice friendship with Dasaraji Maharaj, meeting, watching that Ravan taking, abducting, Ravan abducting Sita. At the same time, that big Pakshi, this bird, this bird Jatayu fighting with Ravan up to the last moment. Our Ramchandra in one hand catching Sita and one hand with, his sword. Fighting, big fighting going on. After that, somehow, Ravan cut his one, wing. After that, he cannot keep balance. After they fall down, after the waiting with blood and blood coming, waiting to give this information to Ramchandra, waiting for Ram. Yes. After that, Ramchandra somehow coming this way and finding, oh, Tato, what happens, uncle? But this way, your wife, Sita Devi, abducted by Ravan. What? Yes. And I wanted to protect, but he wanted to kill me. And I lose my one wing. Now I am waiting for you to see your lotus feet. I am going to die. Ramchandra is so merciful that he took Jatayu in his own lap and with tears give Abhishek. Abhishek, with tears, doing obhishek to Jatayu and blessing him, give him mukti. This way Ramchandra is so merciful after them making friendship with a second time. After this point, then Ramchandra going in Rishasinga Parvat mountain, they meet in Sugriv. Because Sugriv enmity with Bali, this why I don't like to discuss. Hanumanji meeting there. After that, they are planning how to rescue Sita. In the meantime, I would like to say one point, that Sita Devi is not actual Sita Devi. How we came to know? When this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to South India, he meet when one devotee who is doing Ram Bhajan. There one day he invite Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to take bhiksha. But late noon time, Ramchandra asking, why you are not cooking? Actually, how to cook? Actually, Jagat Mata, Sita Devi, Ravan touching Sita Devi, I cannot tolerate. So today I am going to fast. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu become very happy. Your bhajan is very successful. Your mood is very, very nice. But believe that Sita is not your Sita. You are not Jagan Mata. He is actually duplicate Sita. Huh? Duplicate Sita. How I can believe? I can prove it. After that, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming back from one place in South India, at the bank of Paishani Nodi, they find some Brahman discussing Ramayana. There, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu hearing that duplicate Sita, not actual Sita. When Ravan wanted to catch Sita, at the same time Sita Devi crying, then Agnidev came and keeping actual Sita very secretly and giving duplicate Sita in front of Ravan. So Ravan actually catching duplicate Sita. Ravan have no power. Actually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving this Siddhanta in front of this Brahman, when Brahman crying, Ramchandra speaking, how you can expect that Ravan can touch Sita Devi? Ravan is Sarup Shakti of Ram. Ravan even cannot see Sita Devi. What to speak about touching? Ravan cannot touch Sita Devi. What to speak about touching? So be careful. You make prasadam, I like to take. You also enjoy taking prasadam. Don't cry. Now here is your evidence. I come from that Brahmin, society. I get evidence. Yes, see, it is written. What is written? The duplicate Sita, Ravan abducted duplicate Sita, not actual Sita. Then that Brahman become very happy. Now, Ramchandra took decision to go to Lanka. Before that, Ramchandra sending Hanuman to take preliminary information there. So Hanumanji is Superman, flying and going to Lanka and taking information. How to take? Hanumanji taking information everywhere. After that, he got the crew where Sita Devi is, there, confined in one place. It was Ashok Kanan, one garden there. All Rakshas, they are watching Sita Devi. Sita Devi crying in between. Oh Ram, how to get escape this way? Then Hanumanji took the form of, not butterfly, ordinary fly, and coming in front of Sita Devi and speaking, I am Hanuman, I am the messenger of Ram. Yes. Then there, giving the ring. Ring of Ramchandra. You know this ring? Yes. It's my Prabhu Ramchandra wearing. Yes. To identify, so that you don't misunderstand me, I am coming with this ring. So you identify, I mean, messenger, sevak, I mean, your servant. So be careful, Ramchandra very shortly coming to deliver you. Don't cry. Then after that, Hanumanta Lala, he want to burn up total Lanka. One day, somehow, in front of Ravan, he came. And Ravan was saying, who are you? I am the servant of Brahmachandra. But before that, when that monkey was caught red-handed, then actually Superman purposely he come in front of soldier. Somehow they catch and bring in front of. Ravan's giving order. His tail is there. You can set fire so that he can die. After that, you see, with growing fire, they get set fire with this tail. With that tail, burning tail, Hanumanji ill, jumping here and there. So in this way, he is burning whole Lanka. Everybody dying because his leg is there, tail is there, burning. He is going and touching anything, all burning. Whole Lanka burnt up, actually. After that, what to do? Actually, after that, Hanumanji Maharaj putting this, this fire inside his mouth. So this face become black. Sutta Devi also blessing him, that all your race, any Hanuman taking birth, you can see their faces black, blackish, this way. But Ravan again catch him. Ravan say, who are you actually? Actually, I am the servant of Ram. You are servant of Ram. I thought you are so mighty man, powerful. I thought you are, king of some kingdom. I thought you are big, powerful king. But you are servant? Yes, I am servant of Ram. But first of all, Hanumantalala asking, thinking, how to identify myself? When Ravan asking, who are you? Then he is thinking, if I identify myself, he cannot understand. Then Sita Devi coming in here, very in fine form. My son, you identify yourself as a servant of Ram. Then Hanumanji speaking, I am servant of Ram. Then Ravan sitting on a big throne. Hanumanji speaking, I am servant of Ram. So my position is higher than you. So Hanuman with his own tail growing, and making one big, singhasan, throne, and jumping and sitting on this. Ravan is now down. Ravan down. And Hanuman is up. I am servant of Ram. So my position is up than you. Ramchandra coming shortly to kill you. Well, kill me? Let me see. I like to meet him. After that, with full troops, by the blaze of Ramchandra, Hanumanji Maharaj throwing all big stone on sea. And those stone, they are floating on water. Ram, writing Ram, and throwing the stone. By the blaze of Ramchandra, the stone floating on sea. This way, is making full bridge up to Lanka. Still today, from internet, the scientists, they discover, while Ramchandra coming back, then Samudra Dev, and Varun Dev asking, hey Prabhu, you are going back, why you tied me by bridge? Will have to make me free. Ramchandra making, by arrow, throwing, then that bridge is fractured, and still today, from Tetaju, now today the scientists, they are watching from internet, that those stones, in assembly, one by one, up to Lanka, that stone bridge is there. Still today, they discover that. This way, actually, Ramchandra fighting with Ravan. Ravan is also not ordinary personality. You already know, Jai Vijay first took birth as, Ravan, and first, Hiranyakashipu, after Ravan Kumbhakarna, then after the, Shishupal and, Dantabarka, this way. So this way, Ravan want to fight with him. Big history actually. After the big fighting going on, Ravan has 10 heads. 10 heads. One head, Ramchandra shooting another head coming, shooting another head, another head coming. This way after last time, you know, Ramchandra shooting, after that he is going to die. After that, everybody crying. Mandadari, the wife of Ramchandra, crying. But that Mrityuban, the cause of his death, one special arrow was there. Inside one, you know, inside one pillar. Nobody knows. One day, in the form of Brahmin, you know, Hanumanji entering the inside Rajprasad kingdom, they are meeting Mandadari, getting some bhiksha, and speaking in front of Mandadari, Mandadari, be careful. That arrow should be very careful, otherwise you cannot save your husband. Then she thought, is very nice Brahman actually. Brahman is just like Supreme Lord. You can believe him. So he's speaking, no, it is confined in this, you know, in this pillar. Very nicely, nobody knows. Then Hanumanji kick and break and taking this arrow and reach Ramchandra. Because that was special and blessing. Without that arrow, you cannot kill. This way, up to last moment, Ravan fighting, son of Ravan, Mohiravan, Ohiravan, they also fighting. Brother Kumbhakarna also fighting. Everybody fighting. All defeated. After that, Ram and Laksham, after great victory. First, they when they started to go to Lanka, that is called, you see, that is called Vijaya Dasami, Vijaya. And Diwali, at the time of Kali Puja Diwali, when you can find that, when every, it is the usual rule in India, all, you know, domestic people, they are lighting light in every household, you know, devotees, you know, they are all doing this. So that day is a victory. So Vijaya Dasami, the last day of Durga Puja, then Ramchandra started with full troops, and the day where the in Diwali, Ramchandra come back in chariot Pushpakrath, in a full troops, they are coming back, you know, with flowers and everything, water, you know, drenched by those demigods, they are singing in a heaven, and there then Ramchandra with full troops coming to Ayodhya back. After 14 years, Ramchandra landing, you know, Ayodhya, everybody dancing and crying, you know, full of ecstasy. After that, Ramchandra took, you know, care of that kingdom. Bharat crying after a long time, I am looking at your lotus feet. Prabhu, you take your charge. I am less interested about this. I only want to serve your lotus feet. After that, Ramchandra became king. After that, they are leading their household life. After that, Ramchandra, it was the usual rule, that time king, like Prahlad Maharaj and all other king, usual rule, they are going outside, you know, they are going outside kingdom. Kingdom in this palace, to know the grievance of all ordinary, you know, people. Very ordinary base. Prahlad Maharaj also used to do. This way, Prahlad Maharaj meet that Ajagar Tapasvi. There's nice history is there. I have no time to discuss this point. This way, actually, Ramchandra going outside in the night time. In ordinary base, ordinary clothes, going. Nobody knows he is Ramchandra. Very ordinary base, and running here and there to watch. Is there any grievance? Is there any grievance among my, you know, praja subject there? See why he wanted to know. In from one house he heard husband or wife there quarrel going on. Hey, you must go out. I cannot allow you to stay in my room. Husband speaking, I am not like Ram. I cannot allow second time. Because Sita Devi gone, was bound to go there Lanka. After that, about his chastity, there is some question, and he want to speak. So I cannot accept you. You go out of. Ramchandra came to know, everybody expressing doubt about Sita's chastity. I like to prove it that Sita is you know, still today, most pure, you know. Then Sita Devi, in front of Sita Devi, Ramchandra speaking, what to do? I am actually Marjada Purushottama. So you will have to appear in one testing. I like to light fire, you will have to enter into fire and prove that your chastity is 100% perfect. Then after that, Ramchandra invite, you see. In the meantime, Agnidev giving this Sita, actual Sita in front of Ram, and duplicate Sita gone this way. And in Lanka, there is big celebration, in Ayodhya, there is big celebration going on. Now after some period, when Ramchandra came to know, everybody expressed doubt. So he expressed this point in front of Sita Devi, you will have to appear in this. Sita Devi crying. Do you have any doubt about me? Do you have? No, I have no doubt, because you have to prove it. Then entering into fire, no fire, fire can do no harm to Sita Devi. Sita Devi coming out of fire, then everybody knowing Sita Devi's chastity, 100% perfect. After the second time again, this kind of point, again second point arise, then you know, Ramchandra sending Sita Devi to exile again. There in exile, she give birth to two boys, one is Love and Kush, there. Same. This way, Ashwamedh Yajna arranged, Lakshmanji going crying and crying. See, he always, Lakshman think, she is just my, like my mother. I never see his, you know, face. I always look down, a lotus, you know, lotus feet. This way actually, going to keep him there in forest. Then Sita Devi crying, she cannot meet his husband. But Ramchandra is very, very, crying. But what to do? Ramchandra is Marjada Purushottama. After that you see, then their love and Kush grow up. Then Ashwamedh Yajna when started, there is one rule that horse should be thrown. Horse can run. Any king like to catch, they should have to prove their, you know, power. They can, they will have to fight. Otherwise, Ashwamedh Yajna cannot be completed. Then Ramchandra got information, this horse of Ashwamedh Yajna, horse confined by two young boys, very small boys, Love and Kush. What? Small boys, go and get free. Otherwise, how I can complete? Then they are going, you find two small boys fighting with, you know, with Lakshman. Lakshman become very surprised. How is that possible? Two small boys fighting with full bravery? This way? After that, Lakshman could know, it's not possible. After that, Lakshman came to know, there is a son of Ramchandra, otherwise not possible to fight with me this way. This way actually, after that Sita again came. After that again, some question of testing came. Then Sita Devi praying in front of Prithivi Devi. And Prithivi Devi crack in front of Ramchandra. Sita Devi going down and down patal. Sita, actually Ramchandra crying, Sita, Sita, Sita. Sita Devi not hearing anything, going down. After that, Sita Devi gone. Ramchandra bursted into tears, what to do? I lose my wife, I mean Sita, though there is no separation. Shakti, Shakti Mato Ravet from Vedanta Sutta, Sita Devi and Ramchandra, unique tattva, same. They say there is so many, you know, point I like to discuss, but point is very limited. Actually, time is very limited. Hanumanji Maharaj, one point, Hanumanji Maharaj we find in Bhagavatam, Hanumanji Maharaj crying, Na janamanu namana mahato naso vagam. Na janamanu namahato naso vagam. Na bang nakriti tos hetu. Toir yad visistanno pina banu kasaha. Chakara sakshe bata lakshanagraja. Hanumanji Maharaj, in King Purush Varsha, there is division in India. There Hanumanji Maharaj you can find his Acharya. He is worshipping Ramchandra daily and teaching us how to worship Ramchandra. There we find one sloka in Bhagavatam. Na janamanu nam mahato na sovagam. Na janamanu nam mahato na sovagam. Na mang na buddhir nakriti to sehetu. Toi rijat visistan no pino banu kasaha. Chakar sakshe batala kanagraja. There Hanumanji Maharaj, Acharya, wanted to prove that I took birth in beast. I am beast, Hanuman. I am not nice looking. I am not Brahmin, I am not from high family. I have no education, nothing, but still Ramchandra giving me full kiva. Lakhanagraja, Ramchandra giving me full kiva. Manojavan maruti tulla vegam, jitendriyam buddhimatam barishtam, batatmajam banarayajutam uksham, siram dutam tamaham mamastu. Vancha kalpadurvasya kipa sindhu bhavacha, patitanang pavane bhavishna bhyo namuna.